after conferences, we have lunch. Today, of course. But usually lunch is over there in the opposite direction. Just come. Not this, but if you go to Vera, because well, you'll see in the ancient quarter where we there's a great net that is that's so it's not a joke, but it's okay.
Yeah, great. This is what it's like. I'm excited about it. It should be good.
Okay, so this is the last moment.
This room is really important. No.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Wow.
Ooh.
So this is the medieval and Renaissance part of the building, and once upon a time, this room was the dining room of the ancient Oscan. Okay, so it was the room where they used to have lunch, and then when the university built Palazzo Bo, this became the great hall, so the most important lessons were held here. Galileo Galilei used to have lessons here, to teach here, because it was the greatest room, the most important room. You can see Galileo's portrait on top. Can you see him over there? On top of you? Hey, Galileo. So Galileo, he left here in 1592 until 1610. So all the frescoes that you can see here in the room were made in 1854. And these are the last frescoes that we can see. So we cannot see nothing of the ancient Ox Inn. Everything was painted again and again and again in the centuries. Okay, so 1854. You can recognize Galileo Galilei over there, and Morgagni. Morgagni was a really famous medicine teacher, first anatomologist in the world. He lived here. Petrarca, maybe you know what Petrarca is? Petrarca was one of the... Dante and Petrarca are the two... He lived here in Padova City. Okay. In the room, maybe one of the most important things to describe are the crests that you can see all around here. And we have almost 3,500 crests here and we have so many crests to remember all the most important students that studied here now in Middle Ages and above. I remember that it was so great in the contest that on that time the rectors were not yet before 1688, to the 1688, they
Was it also an idea that they did not want to have to show off
Bigger
signs?
And that's why they decided to stop. Because at the beginning, press were literally small and just painted. But then, those crests became bigger and bigger because having a big crest was symbol
more
of
important.
Power and importance. And so that's why you can see things like that.
Yeah.
And so they just decided to stop. Okay.
Can you stand over there?
Sorry?
Can you stand over there? Is he allowed to stand over there?
Okay. Yeah. You cannot seat, but if you just want to stand as the rector does,
yeah.
You can. And usually, Galileo Galilei taught here. We know that the room was full of students, almost 600 students coming here just for him. And so that's why nobody could see him, because the room was so crowded up. Well, you know, cheap seats on that could see nothing. So that's why students decided to erect a big and high podium so that he could go on top and everybody could see him. We still have a podium, the original one. Once upon a time it was over there, now it's in the next room. You two just come with me, we will see the podium. So in 1610, he went back to Tuscany when he was born, and once in Florence, Inquisition arrested him. So that's why before dying, he wrote in his memory book that the period here in Padova City had been the happiest of his life because of this great tolerance, this great freedom of thought, even because of the religious tolerance granted here. That's really important. On that time, especially after Martin Luther reformed, so Protestant reform, Padova was the only one Italian university to welcome even people that were not just Catholic, but even people of other religions. If you were Protestant, Jewish, Muslim, you could not study in Italy, just in Padova city, because it was the only one that didn't ask you which religion was. Okay, so that's why Padova was full of people coming from every single part of the world. They wanted to come here. And that's why around you, you can see 40 different men. They were 40 most famous foreigner students who started here. And maybe you can find people of your nation too. So lots of German people, like Holland people too. All of them came here because of the religious tolerance here. So they started here well young, and then they became really famous. Are you Poland? No, Poland? No.
Sorry?
Someone is from Holland. Holland. Ah, Holland, yeah. You. Ah, Holland, Dutch.
Hollandaise.
Hollandaise.